Hello and good morning and welcome to Fort Benning. This is the ISSF World Cup and it's day 5 of 5. You join us for the start of the 10-metre air pistol mixed team final. My name is Rory McAllister. I'll be your commentator this morning. And joining me from the United States PR team, good morning, is Jessica De Los Reyes. Hello.
Good morning. Hello.
Very excited to have you here. We're just about to hand over to our announcer, Jamie Stangreem, to introduce our athletes for this final.
On firing at points A, representing Spain, we have Pablo Guerrera and Sonia Franquet.
This is Guerrera and Franquet, the Spanish team on firing point A.
On firing points B, representing Greece, we have Dionysis Korakakis and Anna Korakaki.
So Korakaki and Korakakis make up the Greek team. They're on firing point B.
Moving on over to firing point C, representing Serbia, team 2, we have Bobana Moncilovic, Velicovic, and Damir Grigic.
So Grigic and Moncilovic, Velicovic. Moncilovic, Velicovic, who has made finals already this week, so no stranger. That's the first of our two Serbian teams.
Of America is Nicholas Mara and Alexis Legan.
So Mara and Legan make up the home team. So perhaps the chance of a medal for the United States. In this home at World Cup. And Arunovic and Miketz always with the dance as they start. They did that in Changwon.
Oh my goodness, they are the cutest.
Yes.
That is adorable.
They are a great team. And they're the second Serbian team for this final.
And the chief range officer for this final is Mr. Earl Liverland of the United States of America.
So there's Earl Liverland. He's our chief range officer for this final.
There we go.
He's been conducting all of the finals this week. And there's Olegario Vasquez Rania, the current ISSF president and outgoing as well, officially announced his retirement in Changwon at the World Cup last month. So Jessica, nice to have you here.
Thank you for having me. This is exciting.
There'll be three series of five shots in total. So that's 15 individual athletes and 30 per team before we move into the single shots. First two single shots will signal our first elimination. That will continue until the bronze medal has been decided. Then we'll have three single shots to settle the gold medal. For the single shots, I have been informed that the clock will start after 10 seconds. So that's a notice that for the single shots, the clock will start after 10 seconds.
Okay, so here we go then. We've just had the rules explained
for your first competition series
by our announcer, Jamie Stangreem. We're going into the first series of five shots. This is two shots per athlete, so 10 shots in total.
I'm just sitting here on bated breath. I'm just so excited that we've got our American team in here. It's been a little bit of a dry spell, but I'm feeling the good vibes, and I know you've got a lot of good shooters here, and I'll try not to be too biased.
It's okay. We haven't had any British representation this week in the finals, so I haven't had to worry about getting behind the home team. Here's Arunovic and Miketz of Serbia. Great teammates, these two. They really do get on. There's so much character as well. I mean, if ever you're around, certainly Zorana Arunovic, then you certainly know she's in town.
Absolutely. And they're just the nicest people. They are so happy to shoot and even help people in this sport, which is so nice to see.
Exactly, yesterday Arunovic picking up the silver medal, Anna Korakaki taking gold, and they're great friends, the pair of them, and it was hugs all round, and again, so nice to see, because you know you are competing at the end of the day, this is your career, these are medals, and to still have hugs, and you can see it as well, the genuine friendship.
Yes, and because you can still be a fierce competitor, want to win, do the best for your country, and still be a nice person, which I've worked in other sports. You don't see that in other sports as you do in the shooting sports. And particularly at the international level, it'd be so easy to be like, I hope they do blah, blah, blah. But they support each other and help each other because they know it makes them a better competitor as well.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, I wholeheartedly agree. Having worked in a range of sports, I certainly say shooting is up there with being the friendliest. Now, you can't see the targets on your screens at home where you're watching. Perhaps you're watching on local time. It's just coming up to 10:45 here in Fort Benning in Georgia. But wherever you are around the world watching live here on ISSF TV or perhaps even on Facebook Live, then you're very welcome. If you have just joined us, this is the 10-metre air pistol mixed team event, which will be an event that will then go on and forward to the Tokyo Olympics and possibly even beyond, depending on its success.
Mm-hmm. So one little tidbit about our U.S. team. It was so nice to see Nick Maurer shot at 392, which that's his average for 40, but you know, men shoot 60 shots in their competition. But he actually won his only World Cup medal in prone rifle here in Fort Benning 2 years ago. So if he gets one here, he's going to now have one in rifle and in pistol. And there's a very small group of people who can say that.
That actually have achieved that, yes. You'll never find me on that list. It's okay.
You know, watching this competition, it's been interesting to see how, even though they're individual shooters, ways they find to work together. What firing point are you on? When are you going to shoot? Should I shoot first? Should you shoot second? Do we give each other high fives? Do we acknowledge each other at all?
Well, this is it, yes. I mean, there's no rule necessarily that says the man or the woman has to shoot first. You can choose in the individual teams. For example, the Spanish have gone for a man then lady combination, and the Serbians, for example, have both gone for the women first and then the men. As long as she sticks to the order, you're okay. So Spain lead the competition at the moment on 100.6. There's still only a difference of 0.7 from the first Serbian team, which constitutes of Momcilovic, Velocovic and Gligic.
For your next competition series, load.
And the United States find themselves in third position, where if they can keep this position, then a medal will be theirs. But there's still a long way to go. So that's the first series of five shots. That's 10 in total, five per athlete. We now move to the next series of five. Here's Zorana Arunovic, already a medalist from this week.
Wow, check out that air pistol. That's a piece of art right there.
It's almost in Brazilian colours. There must be a reason for that. It must be the one she's used in the Olympics.
I've also been hearing comments from some of the international competitors. They've been amused by our American music.
Well, the show must go on by Queen is what's playing at the moment.
I know, I happen to mention when it's not an American band. No.
But you forgive people for thinking even perhaps that, I mean, well, Freddie Mercury is from you know, Zimbabwe, was he not?
I believe so, yeah. He was like of Indian descent from Zimbabwe or something, of course, UK. But we've had some American country music we've been introducing people to here.
Which is wonderful. We had ZZ Top on yesterday.
Absolutely.
That was great.
You know, everyone goes crazy for a sharp-dressed man, and now that we've got people matching in this team event.
I think Earl Liverland could be a member of ZZ Top, our chief range officer.
Absolutely.
Next time he comes on screen, you will see why.
Here in the US, we always joke when we introduce him. He is the Earl of Liverland, the man, the myth, the legend.
He's a great guy, and he's been superb throughout this week, actually, commanding these finals. It's
We have a whole team of volunteers that take vacation. They come on their own. A lot of them pay their own way, and we don't ask them to do that. They just do it because they love to be here, love to work with these international athletes, the best in the world, and they're just excited to be a part of an event like this. So We have to thank these people for helping us put on something like this, because we absolutely could not do it without all of their help.
And this is it, and as Jessica's just said as well, I mean, huge event here. 350 shooters have come to the World Cup here throughout the week here at Fort Benning. Some 53 nations have been represented as well over the last 5 days. This is the last day of senior finals. Tomorrow we move to youth finals. There are 4 finals in total. Tomorrow, 2 athletes from each final will go forward to the Youth Olympic Games at Buenos Aires, which is later on in the year.
And these kids, you see them here watching their idols compete, and they're so excited to finally get their chance on this firing line to prove themselves as well. So that's been really neat to see, too, that youth energy coming in here.
So this is the Spanish team of Carrera and Franquet. Pablo Carrera, who picked up a bronze medal earlier on this week. He was also 6th in the London Olympic final and was 10th in Rio, just missing the final. But certainly has a medal cabinet to his name. Gold medals in the World Cup in Rio in 2016 and in Munich 2014, and also has a gold at the European Championships from 2012 as well. This is Gligic of Serbia.
And look at that focus.
Yeah, each shooter is so individual. I mean, Gligic goes with his sleeve half rolled up. Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, Momcilovic, Vlotsovic, its sleeves all the way down. Some of the men are in T-shirts. Arunovic of Serbia is in a T-shirt. It all just depends. Mm-hmm. It's just down to your own individual preference.
Hedler, the 100.6. They're up into second place. They're moving Serbia down into third. Spain remain the team to catch. Got 2.2.
So Spain maintain their lead then on 200.3. There's now a difference of 2.2 from the Greek team. That's Korakaki and Korakakis. And then the first Serbian team. That's Momcilovic, Vlotsovic and Gligic are in third at the moment. United States move from third down to fourth for the moment. And the second Serbian team. It's the second Serbian team of Arunovic and Nikets who are third. And it's the first Serbian team, Momcilovic, Vlotsovic and Gligic, who are in fifth position at the moment. So Jessica, your role in the PR and the US shooting team, you clearly enjoy it. You're clearly into this.
I love it. I wasn't a shooter when I came to this sport. Believe it or not, I was kind of found via Facebook, like, you need to come work for us. And it's, okay. But the reason I've stuck with it is it's the people who do this sport. Yeah, it's been interesting learning about what's involved with it, the focus, the dedication, how it's such a, you know, where other sports are bigger and faster, and this is like stillness and precision, and it's almost, I don't want to say the anti-sport, but it's in a microcosm compared to the other Olympic sports, and it's the people who are so interesting. That's what's kept me here, and you could say that about any of these athletes out here. I've had the privilege of meeting the Serbian athletes. Anna from Greece she's an amazing person, and they're so happy to share their knowledge and what they do. As we've talked about before, you don't see that in other sports. So that's been really exciting to be a part of, and that's why I love it. I talk about my athletes. I know I'm the PR person. I know that. The coach can say that. Their parents can say that. I look at them as my athletes as well, because I'm the one writing about them.
Taking their pictures and...
And I'll admit I'm having a hard time talking because I'm like, come on, guys, you can do this. And I'm trying not to be that person because I know we've got a lot of great athletes out here. But, of course, I look red, white, and blue all over. So,
yeah.
It's just really exciting.
Well, you are live to the world at the moment, Jessica. So if you're just joining us, this is ISSF TV. Good morning to you. Local time here is just coming up to 10:55. We're in Fort Benning in Georgia. This military facility, some 26,000 soldiers of the US military come through this facility each and every year. It's also the Center for Excellence and Maneuverability.
Yes.
And the soldiers then deployed either abroad or elsewhere around the United States. But yes, no fewer than 26,000 per year. This entire facility here at Fort Benning is incredible. It's huge. It has its own gas stations or petrol stations, if that's what you call them. It has its own shops, its own housing, its own highways. It's just huge. But then let's face it, we're in the States. Apparently everything's
bigger here.
Yeah, it is. Everything's bigger. The malls are bigger. The gas stations are bigger. The cars and trucks are bigger. I mean, I saw a Dodge Ram yesterday, and it had been raised, and it had like monster truck wheels on it. You're just driving down the road, my friend. I mean, really?
I don't know how they drive them. They're so big.
Do you need that?
I don't. I drive a little toaster of a car.
It's good enough to get you around.
Absolutely, but this facility, a lot of people think, the United States, we have gun ranges everywhere. But to do Olympic-style shooting, we have a range at the Olympic Training Center where USA Shooting is located, and then we have this facility, and this is by far the largest, and it's a great place to hold a competition.
USA Shooting, you're based in Colorado, you're not?
So yes.
It's right over the other side, it's over the west side.
Yes, we're in the western United States at the Olympic Training Center, and we're so lucky to have a range right there at our facility. But to come here, this is where we need to come to host a competition of this caliber. And international style shooting is very specialized still here in the United States. Everyone thinks we're a big nation with a lot of firepower, but for the Olympic game, we're still very small and coming into it, so we rely on a place like this to be able to welcome the world to shoot this sport that we love.
So here's how it stands then. Spain lead at the moment on 298.9. That's a difference of 1.7 from Serbia 1, which is Arunovic and Miketz. Then there's a difference of 0.7 down to the Greek team of Korokaki and Korokakis. And then the United States 0.7 behind the Greek team. And then Serbia 2. That's Momcilovic, Vilosevic and Gligic. 4.5 off the pace from the United States in fourth. So the Serbian second team have some work to do in this next series.
And I have to give props, I don't know if that's a strictly American saying, to the ISSF TV team. This operation, being able to watch it live and these angles, I'm geeking out here as a PR person at the amount of cameras and operation that they have here. This is a beautiful production. And, you know, we're lucky to have this to broadcast our sport because, you know, you see him standing there and you see him holding a pistol so still and so quiet. You don't get everything that's going on.
Well, Oligario, the president of the United of not the United States, the ISSF, Oligario Vasquez Rania, pointing out something there that he spotted. So we've had another two shots per athlete. We'll now have another two.
For your next competition shot, load.
And we're moving towards the elimination stage of this final as well.
Oh. Start. I'm just sitting here wringing my hands right now.
Well, so far, the United States are out of the medal places as it stands at the moment. They're in fourth position. It's Spain who still lead. This is some team, though, Carrera and Franquet. They're oozing class.
Absolutely.
I mean, a combined age of 68. So between them, they have many, many years of shooting caliber. Some of the other members of the other team are a lot younger. Alexis Lagan of the United States is still only 25. Nicholas Maurer is only 29, coming up for his 30th birthday in a few months.
Yeah, that Spanish team, I guess they're like a fine wine, you know? Just getting better with age.
Well, indeed. I mean, saying that, though, the Greek team, Korokakis is 19. Korokaki is only 22, so still never known shooting. But as we suspected, they had a 4.5 gap to make up from fifth position to fourth. It was too big in the end. So And the Serbia 2 team, that's Momcilovic and Vlahovic and Gojgic of Serbia, leave this final and take their seats to become spectators like myself and Jessica. There's Tomoyuki Matsuda, the shooter of the year last year. That's the second time that he's been nominated as shooter of the year, and rightly so. He's an incredibly popular shooter from Japan. Everyone loves him. He's such a nice guy too.
Absolutely.
And like this, turns out for these finals and comes along to watch, even if his country isn't even represented.
Yeah, because he's still a student of the game. And also, you can see him, the way he interacts with these athletes, they're genuinely friends. And he wants to see him do well, even if his country or anyone he doesn't know in particular is here. He just loves this game. Like for Alexis, for example, this is only her second World Cup ever. So...
But you've got to gain your experience somewhere.
Exactly. So I guess this is as good a place as any, kind of our, air quotes, home range, perhaps. But you can see, I think, as I was hearing from air rifle athletes, the more excited they get, the more their hold opens up. Same thing, I think, is happening with the pistol shooters. You get nervous, the heart starts beating, and that arm just starts to circle around that target.
So it's Serbia now who lead, Arunovic and Mekic, 359.7. This is a difference of 2.0 from the Spanish team now, who moved down to second position. And the Greek team are 2.3 behind Spain. And the United States 1.7 off the Greek team. So we're moving to the next elimination stage. So the United States have some ground to make up here. A difference of 1.7. Here's Nicolas Maurer shooting for the United States at the moment. On screen at the moment is Korakakis.
I am losing feeling in my hands. I'm gripping them so tight right now.
Probably as tightly as they're gripping the pistols.
Probably. Ooh, good one.
So here's the American team discussing a few things between them. They're probably saying, we hope Jessica doesn't go mad and whoop if we were to get through. But it's not going to be that way for the United States. Once again, they miss out on a medal in this World Cup in Fort Benning here in Georgia. So that's the American team. That's Nicolas Maurer and Alexis Lagan who take their seats.
I'm still so proud of them. Like I said, they're my homies. It's like they're my kids.
I mean, finishing fourth in a mixed team final, there's absolutely no shame in that. That's, you know, and as we've been saying, this is on a world-class World Cup level. I mean,
oh, yeah, and this lineup, there is no shame. Look at who's still out there on the field. These are
seasoned. Yes.
Seasoned and some of the finest in the air pistol event. So,
yeah, I mean, if I was to tot up the medals that have been won by the six athletes that are standing in front of us.
You'd have to take off your shoes, take off your socks,
yeah,
borrow someone else's feet to
I'd need a centipede at least.
Pretty much.
more than likely. So here's Zorana Arunovic. What a character she is too. Each and every time she hears me say her name, maybe on the commentary or on the medal presentations, she says, I'm becoming and sounding more and more Serbian as each day goes by. as the World Cup started, I was 5% Serbian. Apparently today, she said, I was up to 17%. So.
And talking to her, that's a huge compliment. So I would take it, my friend.
Oh, yes. She certainly calls a spade a spade.
Absolutely.
she has her character, and it's an absolutely wonderful one, and long may it stay. So it's Mekic and Arunovic who still lead, 399.5. There's now a difference of 1.7 between Serbia and Spain, and a difference of 1.5 between Greece and the Spanish team. So Earl Liverland calls the commands again. Load. It's so important as well that the athletes adhere to the chief range officer and literally load when he says load and start when he says start. And the shooter on the left of each team must always shoot first. They must always go in that order. Any violation of that, and there's penalties that come into play.
It's been interesting to see how this mixed team game has been developing, but also how people develop their strategies or how they're going to approach it. Because I know our athletes, it's okay, this is what we're going to do this time, and it's been, I think it's going to be a constant working out process as we build up to the 2020 Olympics.
So here's Niketz with that style that he has. He almost ladies as if he's leaning back literally as far as he can.
Representing Greece goes to
but we have the first medal of this mixed team final. And it goes to the Greek team. There we go. Kisses and hugs for Korakakis and Korakaki. And hugs and kisses for their coach as well. That's how it's done in Greece, though. Lots of kisses.
Yeah, we Americans, we need to get on that bandwagon. Everyone's so affectionate.
I've been surprised. I came here expecting to hear a lot of whooping and cheering and hugging, and the Americans have been very quiet.
Well, it's so funny. You come to our national matches, and sometimes
you stop behaving yourself.
No, it's like a golf match or perhaps a funeral. Everyone's so quiet. They're afraid. We don't want to disturb them. We don't want to ruin anything. And I think a lot of our international friends would say that seems so un-American.
Well, can you imagine if we had a tournament in Serbia? If they're all like Arunovic, we'd be in for a great time. Here she is.
Oh, yeah. It'd be a party.
They're leading the competition at the moment. Now, what can Franke and Carrera do here? Because the two teams are level at the moment. This is going to be an exciting finish for this. We're coming down to the stages of deciding the gold and silver medal. If you have just joined us, this is ISSF TV. My name is Rory McAllister, and my guest this afternoon is Jessica De Los Reyes of the United States shooting team.
Hello, everyone.
So some ooze going around the crowd. There is now a difference. They were joint Spain and Serbia, but Spain have regained the lead. And it's a difference of 1.4, and congratulations from the audience. I would say almost this is probably one of the bigger audiences that we've had throughout the week. A lot of the youth teams have arrived today for their finals tomorrow.
Yes.
So I think that's certainly boosted numbers. Some shooters have already flown home.
No, after the Changwon World Cup, we were privileged at the Olympic Training Center here in the U.S. to host a lot of the Serbian shooters who came over. They were like, we're not going to worry about time change. We want to make sure we get here and get ready for this upcoming World Cup. Wow.
So Spain with a 10.6 and a 9.6. That puts their total to 449.9. And it means, now even though both of the Serbian shots were in the tens, it means now the difference is only 0.8. This is a very close finish for this final. When it goes to the gold and silver stages, there are three sets of two shots, rather than just two and two per team for the in between the elimination process. When it comes down to the final, we go all the way to 24 shots each for each athlete, which is a 48 total for the team. So a difference of 0.8. Let's see what happens. So Clara has shot a 9.6. Arunovic for Serbia scores a 9.3. A 9.9 from Franket. And Niketz now
so patient with his hold.
It's only a 9.5. It's not enough. Not enough to clinch the gold.
Thank you well.
And even before he shot, the possibility, well, was impossible. So Spain have won a gold medal. It's another medal for Pablo Carrera. Adds to his bronze medal from earlier on in the week. Sonia Franquet congratulates him. Oligario Vasquez Rania, the ISSF president, looks absolutely delighted. Zorana Arunovic comes over to congratulate the Spanish team. It's a silver medal. That's Arunovic's third silver medal of this week for Arunovic and for Miketz. And it's the Greek team of Anna Korakaki and Korakakis that pick up the bronze medal this afternoon.
Wow, that was quite the lineup that we had for this. This was exciting.
Yeah, it's a good format. I do like it.
Yeah.
And I think it will be interesting to see how it plays at the Olympics.
Absolutely.
I think it'll do well for itself just purely because it's a mixed team event, and therefore I think just the fact that it's a team event as well.
Mm-hmm.
So here we go, just lining up our athletes. Dinianisis Korakakis and Anna Korakaki are the Greek team.
And
they have the bronze medal.
Representing Serbia, team one goes to Zorana Arunovic.
So Zorana Arunovic and Damir Miketz take the silver medal. That's Arunovic's third silver medal of the week. And it means that the gold medal, and what a performance. They led for most of the competition. They're only second for just a brief time. Back in front.
Wow.
Sonia Franquet and Pablo Carrera. Carrera picks up the gold medal that adds to his bronze from earlier on this week. So there we go. That concludes the 10-meter air pistol mixed team final. The victory ceremonies will follow. And later on this afternoon, we'll be back here on ISSF TV at 1:45 for the 10-meter air rifle mixed team event. Jessica, it's been wonderful having you here. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me. This was exciting to be a part of this.
For your accompaniment. So if you have just joined us, you've just missed the 10-meter air pistol mixed team final. You can watch this back on Facebook. It'll also be available on YouTube and on the ISSF website as well. So there we have the Spanish team being congratulated once again by the Serbian team. They can't get enough of hugging each other here, can they? Arunovic and Korakakis, they're very good friends. Looks as if they were going to hug there for a minute.
And I think these athletes really like, they do a sport that's so individual. They get inside their own heads. It's kind of, I guess, lonely in a way. And now they have a partner out there. They have a partner to care about and support. And as you can see, they love being social, love being a part of this. So, look at her.
This is the John Travolta.
Hey.
John Travolta dance. She certainly is a character. Zorana Arunovic. Right, that concludes the final then. We'll be back at 1:45. So from myself, Rory McAllister, from Jessica De Los Reyes, my guest this afternoon, and from everyone here at ISSF TV, we'll see you later on 1:45 local time here in Fort Benning, Georgia. For now, cheerio.